Today, in our last week of What Child Is This, there's some thoughts that go ringing through the drama that you're about to hear. And I think they're echoed in this verse by the Apostle Paul in 2 Timothy 4, verse 8. Henceforth, there is laid up for me a crown of righteousness, which the Lord, the righteous judge, shall give me at that day, and not to me only, but unto also them that love his appearing. We now present, what child is this? I wonder.
I'd always wonder if I had been at the stable that night.
Would I have seen a king or just a baby?
If I'd stood there with the shepherds, listening to stories about choirs of angels.
Would I have asked,
What child is this?
Or would I have known that someday he would be the shepherd of all?
If I'd watched wise men bring valuable gifts
and kneel down under the guard of heavenly wonders,
would I have understood that he was the one in which I'd find all wisdom?
And that he was the greatest gift of all?
Just as that baby was held by his mother,
he would hold me.
Me with his amazing grace.
And his adoption by his father Joseph
would be a picture of my adoption into God's family.
Who could comprehend that this baby who was defenseless,
swaddled in hell,
would someday be the one holding me in his hands?
And his adoption by his father Joseph
would be a picture of my adoption into God's family.
comprehend that this baby who was defenseless,
swaddled in hell,
someday be the one holding me in his hands.
I didn't witness a star moving across the sky,
or scores of angels proclaiming his birth.
But somehow, in the middle of my ordinary world,
this extraordinary baby's birth found a place
in my worn down, beaten up heart.
So, like all those people who saw him,
he's the one I've been waiting for.
To repair me.
Redeem me.
Love me.
Forgive me.
Comfort me.
Help me.
Die for me.
Raise me to life.
What child is this?
He's the one I've been waiting for.
He's the one who comes to save me.
To save me.
To save me.
He's the one who comes to save me.
Emmanuel.